Hello. Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, teacher.
Hello, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay, that's good. Ready? Are you ready for the class today?
Good evening.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm fine.
Okay, you're fine. You're good. You are ready? Ready for the action? Okay. Okay, people. It's 8 o'clock, so it's time to start the class and take attendance. Okay, Alfredo, just on time. So let me take the attendance. Good evening. Okay, the first person is Alexander Emmanuel Presa Rodriguez. Is Alex? Oh, okay. What about Carlos Antonio Gonzalez Nuila?
Present, teacher.
Okay, Carlos. And we have Carlos Pinto. Daniela Elizabeth Ardón.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you, sweetie.
Hey, estás comiendo, te voy a...
Okay, Edwin Elias Ramirez Rivera.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Gerson Otoniel Tovar. Gilmar Alexander Alvarado.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Mr. Héctor Alfredo Marroquín. Okay. Irving Osmin Rodriguez.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Irving. Ismael Isaac Rivera.
I'm here, teacher.
Yeah, I can see you. Juan Francisco López Marroquín.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Karen Michelle Ayala Ayala. You have problems with your microphone. Yes, because we don't hear you. Try. Hello. Okay, now it works. Okay. Luis Carrillo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Mario Alfredo Tejada.
I'm here, teacher.
Thank you. Metsi Damaris Molina. Rosa Anabel Chavez. Silvia Yanel Carrillo.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Verónica Susana Romero.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Jessica Marisol Villalta.
Present, teacher.
David Emanuel Hernández.
Present, teacher.
And Lainey Giselle Bautista Torres. Okay, people, thank you so much.
Now, present, teacher.
Oh, merci. Can you say your names, please? Say your name and present.
Metsi, present, teacher.
Hector, present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Okay, guys, nice. So, let's begin the class today. It's our video conference number. Which number is today's class?
8.
Number 8, exactly. Can you imagine? It's almost half of the course. It's almost half of the course. Wow, time flies. So, yes, today the video conference is about daily routines, activities, practice. And the main thing about today is questions. The class objective, Alfredo, can you read the class objective, please?
At the end of the class, participants will be able to talk about daily routines.
Thank you. Yes. David Hernandez. No, David, I think you have already read the agenda. David ya ha leído la agenda, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm gonna ask Veronica. Please, can you read the activities in the agenda, Veronica?
Repeat, teacher.
Can you please read the activities in the agenda?
Okay, teacher. Agenda, activity one, review of previous class. Activity two, what up, head drawing. Activity three, yes, no, question with do and does. Activity four, daily routine practice. Activity five, wrap up.
Don't worry. Okay, good. So yes, we're going to start with the review of the previous class. So let's start. Do you remember the rules for the third person singular? There are three rules. What is the general rule? Rule number one?
S.
Add S for he, she, and it, you add the S. Or you can add
ES.
ES. Or if the verb ends in Y, in a consonant plus Y.
IES.
Okay, you drop the Y and you add IES. Very good. Thank you, Mr. Alfredo Tejada. So let's transform, or let's make these verbs into the third person form. For example, do. Do is gonna change for?
Does.
Does. So I write ES, I add ES. Añado ES, okay? Go, the same. ES, and it says goes. Yes. What about fries? What about fry?
I.
Okay, fry. I change the Y for? I. E.
I.
Fry. Fly.
I-E-S.
I-E-S, the same. Okay, what about play?
E-S.
E-S?
S.
Only S. 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 Only S. Okay, what about half?
Has.
Ah, half. Changes. Este cambia completamente y va a ser has. Okay. What about catch?
Catches.
I add ES. Catches. Okay. Catches. Pass.
Passes.
I add ES. Passes. Mm-hmm. Passes. I add ES. Okay. What about get?
Yes.
I just add the S, gets.
Yeah.
Gets. Mm-hmm. For example, gets up. David gets up at 10 a.m. Just kidding, David. Okay, fix.
Yeah, fixes.
Fixes. I add. Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. And feed, like feed the dog, feed the cat, feed the turkeys, feed the cows. Like Alfredo every morning.
The S.
You just add the S. Feed, feed. Mm-hmm. And finally, like.
Likes.
I just add the S. Likes. Okay. So we have the summary here. When the verb ends.
Richard.
Yes, Alfredo.
Puede repetir la frase, solo estoy bromeando.
Just kidding.
Just kidding.
Yes, just kidding. I wrote it. It's in the chat now. Just kidding. ¿Son bromas? ¿O estoy bromeando?
Thank you.
Welcome. So we have the third rules. ¿Quién quiere leer la primera? Who would like to read the first rule? Irving, would you like to read? When the verb ends in.
When the verb ends in O. And C H Z H
X
X E Z
S
S
you add S
you add S
E S
mm-hmm. E S do does watch watches wash washes e go goes
goes. Goes. Okay. Goes. The rule number two, Luis Alonso.
Sí, when the verb and in consonant.
Plus.
Plus.
Plus se dice para decir más es plus. P-L-U-S. Plus.
Consonant. Esta sería la. Why?
Why?
Study. Study.
Studies.
Study.
Study. Fly. Fly.
Fly. Fly. Fly. Fly.
Fly.
Yes, guys. Okay. Now the last rule, maybe Hilmar.
Yo tengo una pregunta ahí, el teacher. En la de play, ¿por qué no lleva la ES? Play.
Okay, yesterday I explained que ayer estaba en una de las diapositivas la regla, ¿verdad? Que cuando es vocal más Y, entonces solo se agrega la S. Ahora, si termina en consonante y luego Y, como en study, entonces sí le cambio a IES. Le cambio a IES.
Ah, bueno, gracias.
Ajá, pero en el caso, mire, de study, consonant D, fly, consonant L. Aquí está play como una excepción. Es la excepción.
Déjeme. Continue, teacher.
Please, Hilmar.
Okay. When this is bear.
Ends.
Ends. Any other letter plus S love loves A A
cuando termine en cualquier otra letra solo es you just add the S. Okay, thank you. And remember have okay. Changes to has.
Okay.
Good. Okay. Next activity. Yes, the homework. We have to make, right, the sentence using the third person form. For example, a doctor and the verb is take. What is the third person form of take?
Takes.
Exactly. So we have a doctor takes care of ill people. A doctor takes care of ill people. I just add the S. Okay. ¿Quién me quiere decir the pupil? The pupil. Volunteers, raise your hands, please. This one, pupil. A pupil. Bueno, o si gustan, lo pueden escribir en el chat.
Studies.
Studies, yes, very good. Para ver cómo lo escriben, ¿ok? A pupil studies every day and... and relaxes on weekends. So you can put pupil, a pupil, or a student, right? Studies and relaxes. What about pilot? Find the pilot. A pilot.
Stop.
A pilot. What does a pilot do?
Drive.
A pilot.
Flies.
Ahí miren, ahí está, miren. A pilot. Flies around the world. Flies. Okay. What about a teacher? A teacher.
Teacher.
A teacher. Teaches.
Teaches.
A teacher. Teaches. Teaches. Yes. A teacher teaches. With ES. Okay. What about vet?
What?
Here. Bet is the last one.
Helps.
Okay, excellent. Yes, a vet helps feed animals. Good. What about, let's see, soldier.
Takes. Correct. A soldier, yes, takes care of his country.
Okay, a soldier takes care of his country. Good. What about a taxi driver?
Drives people. A taxi driver drives yes, people.
A taxi driver drives. What about a chef?
Cookies.
A chef.
Cookies. Cooks. ¿Cómo se dice restaurant? ¿Cómo se pronuncia?
In a restaurant.
In a restaurant.
A chef cooks in a restaurant.
Cooks, no es cookies. Cookies es galleta.
Yes. Just cooks. A chef cooks in a restaurant.
¿Y la palabra restaurant?
Restaurant.
Restaurant.
A ballerina.
Dancing.
Dances.
Dance.
Dances.
Dance.
A ballerina dances. Okay. What about a hairdresser?
¿Cuál dijo?
Hairdresser.
Good people hire. Hair.
Yes, a hairdresser. Cuts people's hair.
Hair.
Mm-hmm.
A baker bakes cake. Qué trabado.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what about a painter?
Draws
painting. ¿Cómo se aprende? Or people.
Draws.
Painting draws. Or people.
Painting.
Okay, a painter draw. What is missing? Oh, the farmer. And the baby.
The singer, just to singer.
No, a singer.
Sings in front of many people. Of many people.
In front of many people, okay. What about farmer?
Oh, yeah. Takes care of a farmer of ill. What's the meaning of ill people? Teacher.
Okay, let me see. Which one you said?
Ill people, a farmer.
Oh, ill is sick, enfermo.
Okay, thanks.
You're welcome. What about a dentist?
Take
great care of your teeth. Very good. Thank you, guys. A farmer, dice ahí, takes care of all of ill people. Yo creo que esta sí está mala porque el doctor sí cuida de las personas enfermas, pero a farmer no, ¿verdad? Ahí sería a farmer doesn't take care of ill people. Mm-hmm. Okay, good, very good. After this exercise, ¿lo terminaron, chicos? Did you finish?
No, falta un poquito.
Okay, so I'm gonna leave it here so you can take some notes for the new vocabulary. Okay, and now, guys, are you still practicing? Did you finish? Hello.
Yes, we finish.
Okay. Let me see you if you are finished. Because now we need to be ready for the next activity, okay? You need to have a page in blank. I have my notebook here, and you need a blank page or a blank sheet. Or if you have paper bond, you can use bond paper, a bond page, okay? Ready? And you need a pencil or a pen. Okay, pen or pencil and notebook. Ready? Do you like drawing? ¿Les gusta dibujar? Do you like drawing?
No.
So.
Practice.
I don't like.
Not so much. Okay. But I think that some of you are Picassos. I guess so. Some of you are Picassos, yes. So let me explain the activity. For this activity, as I told you, is the warm-up. And it's called head drawing. ¿Por qué head drawing? Why? ¿Por qué? Why? Head. What is your head?
This is my head.
Okay. Can you tell me the parts of your head?
Air.
Air.
Eyes. Hair.
Nose. Lips.
Lips.
Then
or mouth.
Feet.
Ears. Okay.
Ears.
Nose.
Eyes.
Nose. Eyes. Okay. Good. So right now, it's called head drawing because we are going to put our notebook or our page on the head.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, on the head. So you're going to draw on your head. Excellent, Gerson. Okay, and you have to draw the following first. Ready? Is everybody ready? Is everybody ready? Open your cameras, please. I want to see you. Is everybody ready? Almost.
Yes, we are ready.
Luis, Metzi. Good job, Veronica. Good job, Jessica. And Carlos also. Okay, nice. I would like to take a picture, but no, I can't because I am having my notebook here. Okay, so you have to draw first, and I'm gonna do it with you, a big circle, big, big circle. Uno que les quepa todo, but you don't have to see. Lo van a hacer en la cabeza, on your head, sin ver, without seeing. Okay, a big circle, así como lo estoy haciendo yo.
No,
sí. Alex, don't see it. No tienen que verlo.
No sé.
On your head. It has to be on your head. Okay, the next is that inside the circle, you have to draw eyes. Okay? Eyes. And also draw a nose. Okay, a nose. Draw a mouth. Okay? Una boca, mouth. Draw hair. Short, long,
curly,
or straight. And it could be for a man or a woman. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And finally, what is the last thing? Ears. Okay? Yes. Ears, orejas, ears. Did you finish?
Yes.
Okay, now let's show our drawings.
Oh my
god.
Oh, good. Ugly.
It's ugly. Good, Michelle. Nice, Carlos.
I like it.
Very good, Ilma. Okay, Daniela, Elizabeth. Okay, Rosy, Gerson. Alex, let me show.
Alias Picasso.
Wow, Elias. It's abstract, abstract art. Abstract art. Oh my goodness. Okay. So now.
Morimos de hambre.
So this is your frame, okay? This is your friend. You need to name your friend. You will talk about your friend, okay?
Freddy.
Using the third person singular. So for your friend, this is an example. Okay, you are gonna say, this is my friend. For example, this is my friend. Her name is Casimira, okay? Her name is Casimira. She's 20 years old.
Oh my God.
She's from Italy. She likes pizza, but she doesn't like sushi. She works in a hospital every day because she's a nurse. And she goes to a disco on weekends with her friends. Oops, sorry. Okay, so you're gonna talk about this person, your friend, imaginary friend, okay, with a partner or in groups, okay? Remember that you have to use third person singular, okay? You have to put the S to the verb. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna give you 1 minute to think about your friend. The name, the age, the things he or she likes. Maybe you can copy the prompts. Alex drawing. Thank you, Alfredo. My goodness, my face. Alfredo. Very enthusiastic. My face is now. Okay.
Are you sleepy?
Yes, I'm sleepy. I'm very tired. Yeah, last night my aunt came from United States and she came like 11 p.m. So at the end we went to bed like 1 a.m.
But you have a lot of presents.
A lot what? A lot of presents.
Present.
More or less.
More or less.
Yeah, it's but then. Nice. During the day, I didn't have time to take a nap to rest. Yes, I didn't have time. That's why I feel tired and sleepy.
I can see.
Yeah, that's why. Yeah, so I need you to participate a lot.
Mm-hmm. We try.
Yeah, okay. So now I'm gonna send you to the breakout rooms and you're going to practice with your group, okay, with your classmates. My friend, I'm looking at your pictures, guys. Oh, Carlos Pinto, curly hair. breakout rooms. Let's go now. Daniela's picture.
Hello. Teacher. Teacher, why are you doing here?
I need to check, I need to supervise, I need to monitor what you're doing. So yes, ignore that I am here, okay?
Weekend. ¿Quién quiere comenzar? No. Está muy feo, pero bien feo.
Horrible.
Horrible, o sea, ugly. Okay. This is Freddy. My horrible friend. My horrible friend.
Horrible, horrible.
His name is Freddy. He is 21 years old. He's from to Chalatenango. He likes to eat pupusas and he doesn't like to eat beans. He works in a factory and on weekends he went to the church. He goes to the church.
Good job, thank you. Alfredo. Okay. Next person.
Anabel, she's excited.
Envió Gerson, envió algo. Vaya, ahí está el ejemplo. David Gerson ha enviado un ejemplo. Para que usted se guíe, tiene que hacer describir a una amiga o amigo suyo. Tiene que, y nos va a escribir, este es mi amigo, y así, ahí está, en el grupo está, cómo es que se va a hacer.
Your neighbor.
Si gusta lo que, en lo que comience a escribirlo, que el compañero Ismael lo mencione, lo que le,
okay.
A quién él va a escribir. Vamos, Ismael, tú puedes.
My friend Maxi. She is I don't know.
La edad de su amiga Ismael. La siguiente
oración es que primero vas a describirlo.
El nombre.
Nombre.
Pues, vamos a inventar o es real porque no sé.
Yo lo inventé.
Tenías que haber escrito, tenías que
haber escrito algo. Mi gata. Okay. Voy a escribir porque.
Voy a decir yo el mío. Yo tengo a alguien, quiero ver. This is my friend. Her name is Estela. She's 43 years old. Or 43, no sé cómo se pronuncia, 43. She is from San Marcos. She likes drink Coca-Cola. She doesn't like eat prawns. ¿Cómo? ¿Camarones?
Shrimps or prawns.
Okay.
Prawns.
She works so hard every day, and she also works on weekends. This is my friend, Estela. Okay.
Hello, did you already practice? Did you finish practicing?
Yes.
Okay.
Finish.
And Jessica?
And I finish.
Person?
Yeah. I agree. I am reading the book.
You're right.
Yes, you're right. I read it in my book.
Oh, okay. Do you talk about your friend with Alex? Ya habló con Alex, ya le dijo de su amiga o su amigo.
Ah, no, estaba escribiéndolo para decírselo.
Ah, ok, you're writing it. Sí, ok. Mm-hmm.
De ahí sería he work
everything.
Every day. Ajá. Pero ahí creo que hay que poner el complemento. He, digamos, works every day.
He every day goes to work. Goes to do.
Sería he goes every day. Every
he day. Goes to work every day.
Goes to work every day.
Goes to work every day.
Se agregaría la S.
Yes.
La E-S. Mm-hmm. Ajá.
And go, yes.
Ajá, goes.
Go.
Every day.
Weekend.
Okay, uh-huh, de ahí sería he.
On weekend. On weekend. On weekend.
La semana.
Le gusta dormir.
He likes sleeping or she likes to sleep.
Like eat pupusa, but he doesn't like eat pizza. No sé si es necesario agregar el verbo comer otra vez. Creo que ya entró, teacher.
Yes, hello.
Escribí, he likes eat pupusa, but he doesn't like eat pizza.
Okay, so the correct form is she likes eating pupusas, she likes eating.
Eating.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. She likes eating. Mm-hmm.
Eating.
Yes, and she's
eating.
She does not like eating pizza.
En ambos, ¿verdad? Mm-hmm. Like eating is doesn't like eating. Bye. Mm-hmm. Eso.
Adiós.
Mucho.
Sí. Is she's
like
on the weekend. She's on the weekend. Work the factory.
She's on the weekend.
Oh yeah. My name is Naya. Her name is Shan. She is 23 years old. She is from San Vicente. She likes book to kids. She ever dance and she on weekends works.
She works on weekends.
Okay, she works on
weekends. Mm-hmm. Weekends. What's on weekend?
Entonces el igual compañero Alexander es she okay. Work on weekend.
Okay, creo que ya nos está llamando ya.
I love this activity.
Yes, yes.
Yes. It's because I can see how the students draw. We can see some talented people. And we can see some people who has other abilities. You can see people with other abilities. Okay, now guys, I just need one volunteer, one person who would like to share with the class about his or her friend. Just one person. Anyone?
Daniel Ardón.
It's volunteering.
Que conste que fui víctima.
You were a victim.
Creo que nos sale mejor que nos diga usted porque sentimos la presión.
La ruleta, ocupen.
Yes, exactly. The wheel of names. Let me see if I have it.
Yeah, vale, voy a decir lo que escribí.
Okay.
This is my friend. His name is Alfredo. He is 28 years old. He likes eating pupusas, but he doesn't like eating pizza. He works every day. He takes a nap on weekend.
Okay. Thank you, Daniela. Excellent work. Okay, so let's continue, guys, with the next part of the class. And now you are going to learn about questions, okay? So, but first, we have some information here about some people's activities in their workplace. For example, Oneida Chicas and Nelly Pineda, they work in the same department, and these are their activities or their duties. Okay, for example, Neide and Nelly create software, repair computers, install antivirus, but they don't sell computer programs and they don't exchange information about programs. Okay, now we have Ricardo Mata and Max Pinto.
Ricardo and Max keep track on the sales. They write reports. They buy new merchandise, but they don't receive money from sales. They don't decide what to buy. Okay?
Coronavirus.
So, coronavirus. No, it's not a coronavirus. Okay, so now about these activities, can you please repeat after me? Create software.
Create software.
Repair computers.
Repair computers.
Install antivirus. Sell computer programs. Exchange information. About programs.
Keep track on the sales.
Buy reports.
Buy new merchandise.
Receive money from sales. Decide what to buy.
Yeah. Buy new. Oh, come on. Ahí me quedé. No, ya.
Buy.
Buy or bubble?
Bye. Pupusas for breakfast or dinner. Okay, so now that we know, you have to read information again and answer the questions. For example, tell me questions. Do Oneida and Nelly work with software?
Yes.
I am repairing computer.
They do.
Yes, they do. Excellent. Yes,
they do.
Exactly. Yes, comma, they do. Yes, they do. Okay. Question number two. Do Oneida and Nelly sell antivirus?
Yes, they do. No, they don't.
Do Ricardo and Max get money from sales? ¿Obtienen dinero de las ventas?
Yes, they do.
No, they don't.
Okay, do Ricardo and Max write reports?
Yes, they do.
Yes, they do.
Okay, number four. Do Ricardo and Max repair computers?
No, they don't.
No, they don't. Okay. And do Oneida and Nelly install programs?
Yes, they do.
Okay. So we have some questions, okay? These questions and answers. Yes, no questions, we do, and short answers.
Okay.
Okay. So, let's go to the next part. We have how to use yes, no questions in simple present. Okay, to make questions in English, we need an auxiliary. In this case, the auxiliary is do. El auxiliar es do. Entonces, para hacer una pregunta en inglés, primero usamos el auxiliar, luego el sujeto, luego el verbo y el complemento, ¿verdad? Vamos a escribir. Vamos a ver acá la estructura. The form is do plus subject plus
complement
in base one plus the complement. And the question mark, obviously, it has to be there, okay? Do plus the subject, plus the verb in base form, plus the complement. We have some examples. Vamos a ver quién nos lee uno, Jessica. The first, the yes, no questions, one yes, no questions, and the short answer.
Okay, babe. Do
early. And you have to read it as a question intonation. For example, do I get up early? Yes, I do. No, I don't.
Yes, I do. Do I head early?
Do I yes, get I... up? Get up. Do I get up early?
Do I yes, I do.
No, I don't. Okay, Rosy? Your microphone is...
Would you call other companies? Yes, you do.
No, you don't.
No, you don't.
Edson, number three.
The jars transport and the products. Yes, the yes. They do not, they do. Okay.
Yes, and the last, Elias.
Do we check the police? Yes, we do. No, we don't.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Good. What time is it, guys?
9 o'clock.
Time to take time to take attendance.
It's time to take attendance, exactly. So let's start. Okay. So Alex, Presa.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Carlos Antonio González. Carlos González. I saw him earlier. Okay. What about Carlos Jaime Pinto?
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Mr. Pinto. What about Daniel Ardón?
Present, teacher.
Edwin Elias?
Present, teacher.
Gerson Otoniel Tobar.
Present teacher.
Gilmar Alexander Alvarado.
Present teacher.
Héctor Alfredo Marroquín Miranda.
Present teacher.
Irving Osmín Rodríguez Jurado.
Present teacher.
Ismael Isaac Aguilar Rivera.
Present teacher.
Juan Francisco López Marroquín.
Present teacher.
Karen Michelle Ayala.
Present teacher.
Luis Alonso Carrillo.
Present teacher.
Mario Alfredo Tejada Maldonado.
Present.
Sida Maris Molina.
Present teacher.
Rosa Anabel Chávez.
Present teacher.
Silvia Carrillo. Ok, Silvia, ay, creo que de que se sentía mal de salud, ¿verdad, Luis?
Sí, me parece que sí.
Uh-huh. Verónica Susana Romero, sí me escribió.
Present teacher.
Jessica Marisol.
Present.
David Hernández.
Present teacher.
Elaine Bautista. Ok. So, and we have now, you will see the formula for creating the yes no questions in the simple present. For example, we have, you can see here, we have do and does. We use do with I, you, we, you, and they. And we use does with the third person singular, he, she, and it. Y luego tenemos el verbo, por ejemplo, do you know this? ¿Sabes esto? Does she know this? ¿Sabe ella sobre esto? ¿O sabe ella esto? Y ahí podemos cambiarlo a otro verbo, por ejemplo, vamos a ver un verbo, díganme uno, one verb, ya se pueden cinco.
It.
Ok, run. Run in the park. Fine. Entonces sería, por ejemplo, I'm gonna ask someone, Alex, do you run in the park in the morning?
Teacher, ¿se puede repetir in the park in the morning? In the...
¿Puede colocar el parque en las mañanas? Yes. ¿Corre en el parque en las mañanas?
Yes, I do.
Oh, really? Wow, good. Good for you. Okay, Alex. Does Veronica run in the park in the morning? Alex, I am asking you about Veronica. Does Veronica run in the park in the morning?
Yes. Yes, she do.
Yes, she?
Does.
Yes, she does. Okay. Now, another thing, maybe another action verb. Okay, let's say study English, okay? Michelle, do you study English?
Yes, I do.
Okay, Michelle, does your mother study English? Does your mother study English?
Yes. I don't know.
Okay, ahí vamos. Let's see some examples. Vamos a ver más ejemplos, ¿ok? In the next one.
Okay, teacher.
Miren, en este tenemos the affirmative statement, negative statement, the question, and the answer. For example, I like ice cream. I do not like ice cream. Do I like ice cream? Yes, you do. Or no, you do not. Or no, you don't. Okay?
Yes, we do.
The second one, you love me. You don't love
you don't,
me.
You don't love me.
Do you love me?
You.
Yes, I do, of course. Or no, I don't. Okay. Now, the third person, he works in a bank. Negative, he does not work
in a bank.
In a bank.
He does work in a bank.
Mm-hmm. Or he doesn't
work in a bank.
Question, does he work in a bank?
Does he work in
yes,
a bank?
He does. No, he doesn't. Okay. She trusts him. Ella confía en él. She trusts him. She does not trust him. Question. Does she trust him?
Does she
yes,
trust
she does.
Him?
No, she does not. Okay,
yes,
next. It works loudly. It does not work loudly. Does it work loudly? Yes, it does. No, it doesn't. Or no, it does not. We know each other.
What's mean loudly? Loudly.
Loudly is with loud volume, like similar to noisy. Loudly, alto, como con un volumen alto, algo que hace ruido. Por ejemplo, my refrigerator works loudly. Mi refrigeradora trabaja con ruido, ¿verdad? Se escucha que está trabajando. It works loudly. Thank you. It doesn't work loudly.
Okay, thank you.
Does it work loudly? Yes, it does. No, it does not. Okay? Next example. We know each other. We don't know each other.
We know each other.
We do we know each
know
other?
Each other. We,
yes,
we
do
not
know. No, we do not.
We do not.
We don't
know. No,
we lie.
We know.
Another example is you like jumping, you don't like jumping. Do you like jumping?
You like jumping?
Yes, we do.
Do
no,
like
we do not. They
do
give money.
Like jumping.
They do not
money.
Give money.
They do give money.
Do they give money?
They
yes,
give
they
money.
Do. No, they do not. Como se fijan, cuando hacemos preguntas, tenemos que agregar el auxiliar, el verbo auxiliar do, que simplemente significa que el verbo esté en presente. Es nada más eso, ¿verdad? Y se utiliza al inicio, solo le damos, bueno, tenemos que poner el auxiliar do al inicio, y luego es como una oración normal, ¿verdad? I like ice cream. Do I like ice cream? You love me. Do you love me?
A mí.
¿Ok? Como ven, no. Sí, la respuesta de in a short answer va a depender si es the subject, va a depender del sujeto que usted utilice. Si es tercera persona, sabe que va a utilizar does or doesn't. ¿Ok? Sí, tengo sueño. Yes, I am sleepy. Very tired, like you sometimes. Okay,
yeah.
So yeah, sometimes I see Alfredo like falling asleep.
Today, one more time.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Yeah, I know we live in very difficult days. Ok, creo que ya les compartieron ahí, ¿verdad? La imagen, porque sí les puede servir mucho. Este está muy completo con todos los sujetos, ¿verdad? I'm sorry. And I think I'm
being sick. Thank you, Alfredo.
Creo que también me estoy enfermando. Ok, pair work. Create a question based on the answer. Vale, miren aquí, tienen que hacer una pregunta de acuerdo a la respuesta. Pero antes de hacer este ejercicio, que este a veces son un poquito más complicados, vamos a hacer uno en línea, ¿verdad? Vamos a hacerlo así como siempre hacemos, ¿verdad? Que nos encanta hacer ejercicios en línea.
Creo.
Así que les voy a enviar el link. The link, I'm going to send you the link. You go to the webpage using the link. And we are going to solve the exercise. Vamos a hacer el ejercicio. Okay? So let me send you the link via Zoom and via WhatsApp. It's already in Zoom and in some seconds, it's gonna be also in your WhatsApp group. This is a worksheet about yes, no questions. You have to use do, does, don't, or doesn't. I think there are 13 exercises. Are you on the web page? Let me know when you get into the exercise. Avísenme cuando ya estén en la página web.
Yo pensé que le había mandado a WhatsApp.
In this moment. Okay, are you already in the web page now?
Yes.
Okay. So you have to write do, does, don't, or doesn't. For example, your brother drinks soda. Is do or does? Is it do or is it does? Your brother.
Do.
Do.
Your brother. First, second, or third person?
Does. Does.
It's third person, right? Entonces vamos a usar does. Does your brother drink soda? No, he.
No, he doesn't.
No, he doesn't. Okay. Next, you eat junk food?
Do you eat?
Okay.
Do you eat junk food?
¿Comes comida chatarra? Do you eat
yes,
junk food?
Yes, I do.
I do.
Yes, I do.
Okay. She get enough sleep?
Does.
Okay. Does she get enough sleep?
No, she doesn't.
Okay, let's continue, please. Continue with the exercise. And when you finish, you can send your results via WhatsApp. Okay. Okay, we have the first, Michelle. Excellent, Michelle. You got 10. Perfect score.
Thanks, Michelle.
Oh, now we got another one, but I don't know who this person is. ¿De quién es ese? No puedo ver de quién es.
Mío, segundo.
¿Verónica?
Metzi.
Ah, Metzi. I'm sorry, Metzi. Okay, what happened, Metzi? Let me see. He. Does he go for a walk? Yes, he does. Does your brothers? Ah, como brothers es plural, entonces es do. Do your brothers drink plenty of water? Yes, they do. El he es does. Does he eat rat meat? No, he doesn't. Okay, now we have Alfredo. Do they stretch in the morning? No, they don't. Okay. The same with the brothers, it's plural. Okay, only that. Good. Do your brothers. Por eso es que llevan do, porque brothers is plural. Okay. Oh, let's see. Alex. Oh, doesn't. The order of the words. The spelling. Your father es como él, ¿verdad? Su papá es él. Entonces, does your father do exercise? No, he doesn't. Your mom is like she. Does your mom stay in shape? No, she doesn't. Okay?
Cierto, cierto.
Vamos a ver, Daniela. Does your brother. Creo que en esa es, ajá, acuérdense que cuando es una tercera persona singular, ya sea él o ella, aunque lleve el possessive adjective, pero por ejemplo, your mom is she. Your brother is he. Puede fijarse en la respuesta. And remember, he, she, and it. Does. Yeah, those were your mistakes, Daniela. Jaime, do your brothers. Brothers is plural. Tus hermanos.
Okay. Tus do your hermanos. Brothers.
Do your brothers.
Okay, teacher.
En negativo, no, they don't. Yes, she does. En las respuestas, acuérdense que si es yes, es do or does. Y si es no, don't or doesn't. Okay. Okay, good job. The majority is finished. So let's continue with the rest of the class. Now you have to work in your book and you have to create a question based on the answer. Let's make the first one together. Hagamos el primer ejemplo juntos. Let's make the first example together. The answer is, yes, he does. He fixes the AC on Friday. So, does, okay. Does he fix? Acuérdense que cuando tenemos la pregunta, usamos el auxiliar, el verbo va a ir en base form. Does he fix the AC
on Friday?
¿Arregla él el aire acondicionado? Yes, he does. Él arregla el aire acondicionado los viernes. Okay, number two, it says, yes, she does. She sends many emails to customers.
No, iba on Friday, teacher.
No sé. Puede ser. Pero puede que no, porque está preguntando, ¿verdad? Pero sí, puede ir on Friday, too. Okay, what about a number two? Yes, she does. She sends emails to customers. Yes, she does. Entonces, eso nos dice que el auxiliar que yo voy a usar es...
Does.
Sujeto, subject.
She.
Does she. Verb in the base form.
Send.
Send.
Many emails.
Send many emails.
Okay. Number three. No, she doesn't. She cleans the first floor only.
Does she clean?
Does she clean? Sin la S, ¿verdad? Does she? Does she clean the second floor, por ejemplo? No, she doesn't. She cleans the first floor only. And number four, yes, he does. Eric keeps track on the sales.
Does Eric?
Mm-hmm. Does
he, Eric?
Does Eric
keeps?
No, no lleva la S.
Keep
track on the sales. Okay. Uh, alguien me preguntó que el ejercicio no lo lleva contractado, pero sí, mire, le dice complete con do, does, don't or doesn't. Entonces sí tiene que escribirlo en forma contractada el ejercicio. ¿Ok?
You are asleep, miss.
Yes, I'm sleepy. Ay, sí, se me nota. Mucho, mucho, mucho. Okay. So now, guys, we have another activity. And this is going to be in groups, okay? In your groups, you have to find someone who eats more than four pupusas, someone who drinks beers on weekends, someone who goes to church every week, someone who works from home, and someone who likes singing. And you're going to write the name. Y pueden escribir una idea más. Una idea más. You add one more idea. For example, what would be the question you need to ask? Bueno, les voy a poner aquí, por ejemplo. Les voy a poner un ejemplo. Vamos a agregar aquí. My idea will be find someone who uses a computer at work. Alguien que use computadora en el trabajo. Entonces, ¿cómo va a ser la pregunta que yo le voy a hacer? Esa es mi idea. Esta es la idea que usted va a agregar. Entonces, vengo yo y le pregunto a alguien, le voy a hacer una pregunta. ¿Cómo voy a hacer la pregunta yo a una segunda persona? ¿Con do o con does?
Do you.
Exactly. Do you. Muy bien, excelente. Entonces yo le pregunto, por ejemplo, a Jessica. Y le pregunto, Jessica, ¿cómo es la última idea, verdad? Donde dice, uses a computer to work. Entonces yo le pregunto, Jessica, do you use a computer at work? ¿Usa una computadora en su trabajo? Do you use a computer at work? Entonces ella va a decir,
yes, I do.
Ok, o ella puede decir,
no, I don't. Oh,
excelente. Entonces, pero ella me dijo que sí. She told me, yes, I do. Entonces, ¿cómo me dijo que sí? Entonces, vengo yo y escribo, Jessica. ¿Verdad? Entonces, si su compañero dice que sí, usted escribe el nombre. Pero si su compañero dice que no, no, I don't, no escribe el nombre. Solo le dice, ok, thank you, my friend. Y you ask another partner. Usted le pregunta a otro compañero hasta que encuentra a alguien que diga que sí. ¿Ok? No sé si están, si mis instrucciones están claras. El juego se llama encuentra a alguien que.
Yes.
Así que si, if your classmate answers no, I don't, just say thank you. Don't write a name. You write a name only if your classmate says yes, I do. And the question is, you have to use questions using do you eat more than four pupusas? Do you drink beers? Do you go to church every week? Do you work from home? Do you like singing? Y lo van a hacer en grupos. Ahorita, justo ahorita les pongo a hacer la actividad. Los voy a hacer en grupos grandes para que tengan allí variedad.
¿Lo puede poner de nuevo, teacher, el cuadrito, porfa?
Lo envío ahorita.
Gracias.
I'm gonna send it in the chat.
Okay.
Okay, Tito, you have to ask and answer questions. ¿O están copiando el cuadrito?
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
No, I don't.
Ahí está, teacher, silencio.
Silencio. Ya no respondo.
Oh, you were asking about the beers. Alex, do you drink beers on weekends?
Alex Presa. Tomar cerveza en el fin de semana. No digas que no, porque tenés beers. Cara que sí.
Do you drink beers on weekends?
Quiero ver. No le puedo decir cantidad, no, mentira. No, I don't.
Okay. Then,
don't believe me.
He's a
don't
good
believe.
Boy. He's a good boy.
No one eats more than 4 pupusas.
No one eats more than four.
I eat 4.
You eat 4, okay.
I eat 3.
No more than.
You eat 3, okay. If my mom makes the pupusas, I eat 4.
Okay.
I accepted invitation.
You accept invitations. Oh, my mom makes delicious pupusas. That's why I cannot eat less than 3. Is it 3 or 4?
Ahí tal vez me como las 4.
Who drinks beers on weekends?
Mire, Alfredo, pero pregunte, do you, a alguien específico.
Ah, ah, ok.
Yo creo que Alfredo quiere invitar a alguien a tomar por eso.
Uno por uno.
Yes.
Ay, Dios, ok. Alexander, Emmanuel Presa, do you drink beers on weekend?
No, I don't.
Jessica, do you drink beers on weekend?
Yeah, you don't.
Hmm.
No, ask Luis or Hilmar.
Hilmar, do you drink beers on weekend?
Do you drink?
I think not, my friend.
No, I don't.
Luis, do you drink beers on weekend?
No, I don't.
Ah, ahora resulta que nadie toma.
Okay, now you ask Alfredo.
That teacher, do you Alfredo? Drink beers on weekend?
No, I don't like beers. They are
in Navidad.
Okay, Alfredo, do you drink beers on weekends?
I don't drink beers.
I drink every day.
Only one.
Only one.
And not all the weekends.
Only one weekend.
Every day.
Only when I am stressful.
Oh, okay. When you feel stressed out. Okay.
Yes. I just drink beers on weekends, okay?
Oh, Daniela.
Mira el nombre. Y si no, tenemos que seguir preguntándole. Pero como todos dieron días.
Hay una pregunta que sobra, ¿verdad? Who's a compost at work?
¿Que esa fue
no,
la
no es que sobra, pero la podemos hacer.
Fue el ejemplo.
Sí, yo la que tengo de ejemplo.
You made the question with your own idea. With your idea.
No, no hicimos de nuestras ideas. Nos dijimos de eso que se mandó.
Ok, sí, sí, pero la última iban a hacer un ejemplo con su idea.
Ah, ok.
Ese pueden hacerlo ahorita. You still have time. Todavía tienen tiempo, lo pueden hacer.
Ah, ok.
Ok, thank you. Ok, thank you.
Okay, guys, did you already finish? ¿Ya terminaron? Did you finish?
No, teacher. Ismael.
Hi, hi.
Do you drink beer on weekend?
Yo le digo a mi mamá que las clases son dos veces por semana, pueden venir temprano, están aquí donde yo vivo y ya después de la clase se va.
Yes, I do.
Yes, I do every weekend.
Correcto, entonces, porque yo le digo que yo sé que ella rápido, eso le va a gustar, eso mantiene su mente ocupada. Y la natación yo he estado leyendo que ayuda a hasta para lo de la vista, porque al día el niño de una compañera comenzó a ir a lo de las clases de natación y todo, que es por
otra vez
así.
Y le dijeron
que la otra vez es la natación.
Ismael, si te escucho bien, no te escucho bien porque se oye mucho ruido.
Se escucha a alguien de su familia platicando sobre unas clases.
Yes. Excuse me. Next panel.
Silencio que está la ticha.
Ya no respondan.
No, ignore me.
Jessica.
Hello.
Do you work from home?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Well.
No, I don't.
Well.
Yes, I do.
Alex.
Yes.
Do you work from home?
Do you work from home?
No, I don't.
No, I don't.
Yes, I do.
I do.
Yes,
you do. You?
Yeah.
I do.
Yes, you work from home.
I work from home.
Okay, next.
Great for you.
Nice for me.
Yo solo en la cuarentena que trabajé desde casa.
Only the quarantine.
Quarantine.
Yeah, I was 3 months ago. I was working at a school, but now I'm working from.
You teach in a school?
I was teaching. Estaba. I was teaching.
Okay.
I was a substitute teacher for many months.
For many?
Months. Five months.
5 months.
Ah, okay.
Five months. From May until October.
Nice. In which one? School?
It was a private a school program. Mm-hmm.
Nice.
For students with low resources. Okay, it's time to go back.
Teacher, tengo una pregunta.
You have a question, okay. Tell me your question.
Teacher, you have a question. En la tercera, donde dice goes to church every week, ahí esa parte, ¿por qué puso goes? Y no do o does.
Es ir a la iglesia. Ir, por eso es goes.
Uh-huh. Ah, vaya, está bien. Gracias.
You're welcome. Okay, so now it's time to share with the class the results of your findings, the results of your questions, okay? And so tell me the name of the person and the characteristic. For example, you can say, Hilmar eats more than 4 pupusas. Or you can say, Daniela drinks beers on weekends. Or Elias goes to church every week. Or Juan works from home. Or Michelle likes singing, etc. Okay? So tell me, who eats more than 4 pupusas? Oh, your ideas.
No, I don't. 3 pupusas. Ew.
Daniela. Daniela eats more than 4 pupusas.
Sí. More than 4 pupusas.
No, I don't. I eat 4 pupusas.
Okay, Daniela eats more than 4 pupusas. So maybe 5 or 6 or 7. We don't know. Okay. Now, who drinks beer?
Okay.
Who drinks beers on weekends?
Alex drinks beer on weekends.
Evening too.
Okay.
Alex don't take back.
Alex doesn't drink beers. He drinks Tic Tac. Okay.
The fruity.
Okay. Who goes to church every week?
Carlos goes to church every week.
Carlos Pinto.
Yes, I do.
He's a good boy.
Yes.
I can see the halo. I can see the halo. Okay, who works from home?
No, you.
Who?
You.
Hector.
Teacher works from home.
Who else? ¿Quién más? Who else besides me? Aparte de mí, besides me, who else? ¿Quién más? Who
Hector.
Else?
Hector says he works from home.
Nice, Hector. Do you like working from home? Hector, do you like working from home? Do you like it or you don't like it?
Creo que entendí mal la pregunta. Creo que era como, yo entendí como trabajar los fines de semana en casa o algo así.
Ah, no, es trabaja desde casa.
Ah, no, no. No,
no, you don't. You don't work from home. Okay, so it's only me. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. You're low. I'm the only one. Who likes singing?
Metsi likes
singing. Really? Metsi likes singing. Is that true, Metsi?
Que cante, que cante.
Queremos escucharla.
An English song.
Sí, yeah. Cante.
You have to prepare.
But in the bathroom, teacher, in the bathroom.
I like singing in the bathroom too. Okay, when taking a shower. Now, good ideas?
I'm saying, do you know to use Bitcoin? Pero no sé si estaba bien hecha la pregunta.
Do you know?
The Chivo wallet era. The Chivo wallet.
Do you use Chivo wallet?
No, la pregunta era que si sabían ocupar la Chivo Wallet.
Do you know how to use Chivo Wallet? Do you know how to use Chivo Wallet?
How? No, how. Ah, llevaba how. Okay.
Sí, porque conoces o sabes cómo usar, how to use the Chivo Wallet. Okay, and who knows how to use the Chivo Wallet?
Do you know how to use the God Wallet?
Yes, I do.
Who? Who knows how to use the Chivo Wallet? Metzi?
Daniela used the Chivo Wallet in her work.
Daniela uses. Oh, okay. I started to use the Chivo Wallet last week.
Congrats.
¿Me puede transferir los 30 dólares? ¿Acepta donaciones?
I do. It's because some friends wanted to share some bitcoins with me because of my wedding. As a present.
Your day?
My wedding.
Para la boda.
Exactly. Don't you remember I told you I'm going to get married this coming Sunday?
Yeah.
On Sunday. I'm getting the next married Sunday? On Sunday.
The Sunday. Next Sunday?
Yes, the next Sunday.
Are you nervous?
No, a little bit.
Are you excited?
Just a little. Yes, I'm very happy. I'm so excited about it. Yeah. Okay, so next
send us picture of your
chum.
Of course, picture. I'm going to the next class after my wedding is gonna be full of pictures. Nah, just kidding. Okay, now in the next slide we have some questions, okay, and you have to create yes no questions using the words in parentheses, and you have to write the answers, okay? So let's write the questions, please.
Good night.
For example, do you work in a company?
Teacher, does it con se puede decir, do they check task product?
Do they check product? Do they check the product?
Does no. La palabra does no.
No, ahí sería como es they, es do.
No, este, cuando después de check puedo colocar, escribirle does product, o sea.
No, the product. Product. The product, T-H-E, el producto. T-H-E.
Ok. Okay.
You can share via chat your sentences, or you can read them. Las pueden leer también.
Teacher, what's mean logo?
Logo, like in Spanish. Okay. Logo. Logo. Hmm? Yeah. Like in Spanish, it's the same. Okay, what about number three?
Do we listen to customers?
Ajá, ahí sería, fíjense que hay una palabra que está casada con listen, y es to. Listen to. Listen to the teacher. Listen to the customers. Listen to the song. Do we listen to the customers? Yes. We do, or yes, you do. What about teacher, the number four? Tell me.
In the number three, I write, do we listen our customers?
Do we listen our customers? Okay, yeah, right. It's acceptable.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Number four?
Did you buy the new material?
Do I buy the new material?
Buy, ¿qué dijo?
The new material.
No, I do.
No, I don't.
No, I don't. Or no, you don't.
No, I don't.
And the last one?
Does Milena and Pablo?
Does or do?
Do Milena and Pablo.
Mm-hmm, porque son they, right? Do Milena and Pablo design the logo?
Design.
Yes.
Yes, they do.
Veronica, yes, they do. Okay, people, what time is it?
It's time to go to the bed. To bed.
It's time to go to bed. Time to go to bed. Especially the teacher wants to go to bed very soon. No, but it's time for the wrap up. Okay. So tell me, what did you learn today? ¿Qué aprendiste hoy? What did
we learn today how to use the simple present.
In questions.
Yes. Yes, no question.
Yes, no questions. We do and?
Does.
Does. Excellent. Can you give me one example, please? You can ask the teacher.
Okay.
Does the teacher go to the bed?
Does the teacher?
Yes, she does after class. Okay. Mm-hmm. What new vocabulary or new words or new verbs did you learn today?
Pupil.
Okay, which is a student?
Loudly.
Loudly. Loud. Loudly.
Loudly. Loudly. Ruidoso. Loudly.
Con volumen alto. Volumen alto.
Loudly.
Mm-hmm. Loudly. Loudly. Audible.
Mm-hmm. Loudly.
Loudly. Okay, I know you're already sleeping and you're already tired and you want to go to bed. So let me take the last attendance. And today it's the turn of Veronica Susana Romero to stay. Okay. So
yes.
Mm-hmm, after you say present, you can leave the class if you want. Okay. Alexander Presa.
I'm here, teacher.
Carlos Gonzalez. Carlos Pinto.
Present.
Daniel Ardón.
Present.
Edwin Elías.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Gerson Otoniel.
Present, teacher.
Gilmar Alexander.
Goodbye.
Present, teacher. Héctor Alfredo.
Present, teacher.
Irving Osmin.
Present, teacher.
Ismael Isaac.
I am here, my fellow teacher.
Juan Francisco López.
Present, teacher.
Karen Michel.
Present, teacher.
Luis Alonso.
Present, teacher.
Alfredo Maldonado.
Present.
Messi.
Present, teacher.
Present, teacher. Okay. Rosy Chavez.
Present, teacher.
Silvia Carrillo. Verónica Susana.
Present, present.
Jessica Vialta.
Present, teacher.
David Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Almost all of you were in the class, okay? So have a good night and see you tomorrow.
Good night, teacher. Bye.
Good night.
Good night, teacher. Bye. Bye.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Veronica.
¿Qué quiere la? Déjame mi morcita. Estoy.
Okay. How are you?
Very well.
Okay.
Thank you.
Good. Veronica, do you have any questions about the topics, the contents? Any doubts? Or would you like to practice your English?
Okay.
¿O le gustaría practicar? In a conversation.
Pues hay cosas que se me dificultan, teacher, porque por ejemplo, lo que usted lo está explicando, sí lo logro entender, pero hay momentos en que ya me pierdo, por ejemplo, en el caso del negativo. Espéreme, que aquí lo había notado, porque ahí es donde no entiendo esa parte de la positive adjective. Esta parte no la lograba entender porque cambia porque cambia cuando las incluimos en una oración. Esa parte.
Por, dígame un ejemplo para poder comprenderle.
Vaya.
Por favor.
Este, cuando aplicamos el possessive adjective, cuando lo aplicamos, cómo logró entender, cómo logró yo hacer ese entendimiento de cuándo, cómo aplicarlo.
El my, your, his, her. Ok, sí. Ese es para indicar que algo es de alguien. Por ejemplo, para decir, you have, no, espérame, vamos a decir otro ejemplo.
¿Pero en qué tiempo está? ¿Lo tengo que poner en presente?
No, eso no es verbo. No es verbo, sino que es un adjetivo. Y se pone antes de cosas. Ajá, y puede ser usado en presente, pasado, futuro, cualquiera. Uh-huh. Por ejemplo, si yo digo my cell phone, estoy usando my cell phone, your cell phone, his cell phone, her cell phone, our cell phone, their cell phones. Entonces digo mi celular, tu celular, el celular de él, el celular de ella, los celulares de ellos, nuestros celulares.
Perdón, teacher, es cuando yo no entiendo. O sea, si yo sé que usted me quiere explicar que es algo que quiere hacer notar que tiene una pertenencia a esa persona, pero ¿cómo diferenciarlo? Que, por ejemplo, que we is our. Ahí es donde yo me pierdo, que le digo. Uh-huh. O sea, esa parte es la que yo no logré como asimilar muy bien.
Entonces,
¿cuándo yo lo
tengo? O sea que lo que le cuesta es cuál va con cuál.
No, ¿en qué momento lo voy a aplicar?
Ok, es eso lo que usted mismo me acaba de explicar para decir que de alguien. Vaya, por ejemplo, si yo le que, si, vaya, le voy a decir una pregunta y usted me la hace en inglés.
Uh-huh.
¿Verdad? Por ejemplo, la pregunta va a ser su mamá tiene, a su mamá le gustan las pupusas, vaya. ¿A su mamá le gustan las pupusas? Es una pregunta. ¿Cómo haría esa pregunta? Estoy diciendo, me está hablando de su mamá, ¿verdad? ¿A su mamá le gustan las pupusas?
Do my mother?
Vaya, usted me haría la pregunta a mí.
Entonces, usted.
Ajá, okay. A mi mamá, de mi mamá.
Su mami.
Ajá, usted me preguntaría a mí, a su teacher, ¿a su mamá le gustan las pupusas?
Do your mother?
Vaya.
Do your Como mother?
Your mother, ¿verdad? Es una, una tercera persona, estoy yo, está usted y mi mamá, estamos hablando de alguien más, de una tercera persona. Entonces, ¿qué usaría? Uh-huh. ¿Usaría tú o usaría das?
Sería das.
Entonces, mira.
Para ella.
Cabal, porque está hablando de mi mamá, ¿verdad?
De su mamá.
Una tercera persona. Entonces sería... Teacher, does your mom like pupusas? Y ahí mira, está utilizando el your. Does your mom like pupusas?
Uh-huh. Igual, entonces, ahí en el caso de los que quiera hablar de ustedes...
Se usa el you. El you es el mismo en singular y en plural.
Eso, entonces eso, teacher, eso possessive adjective lo utiliza cuando dice usted que quiere hacer mención de una pertenencia.
Sí, que algo es de alguien.
Ajá, es que yo esa parte sí.
Les voy a poner este ejemplo. Ahí, perdí. His computer is old. ¿Qué estoy diciendo ahí?
La computadora de él es vieja.
Muy bien. Sí lo entiende, ya ve.
Ay, es que fíjense que esa es la...
Ay, perdón, no me agarró el número. Our teacher is 28 years old. ¿Qué dice ahí?
Nuestro profesor tiene... Nuestra profesora tiene 28 años.
Excelente, excelente. Ahí está.
Es que fíjese que yo en ese sentido, yo entiendo muchos verbos, entiendo este significado de muchas cosas, teacher, pero ya esa parte así es la que a mí me cuesta. Porque yo el significado de muchos objetos y muchas cosas me los puedo y por eso es que voy logrando entender, pero ya cuando se presenta esa parte es que me pierdo. Y está bien porque creo que es la base del idioma, ¿verdad? Esa parte de entenderla. Porque yo, como le digo, hay muchos nombres, muchos que en inglés me los puedo por las películas, por las canciones, por un montón de cosas, pero ya hacer esa diferencia es la que a mí me cuesta.
Sí, lo va a lograr con la práctica, ¿verdad? Lo va a ir logrando, pero yo veo que usted le agarra rápido a las cosas y sí entiende bastante. Los ejercicios la mayoría de veces están correctos, los hace muy bien. Y pues estamos en el nivel 1, ¿verdad? Pero sí, cabal, yo siento que usted
es que otra cosa que...
va al ritmo.
Es que fíjese que otra cosa que me funciona a mí, y no solo en este idioma, sino en el español, es la lógica. Entonces le voy buscando lógica a lo que usted está explicando o a los ejemplos. Pero ya ponerlo así un poco más, como decir, entenderlo a cabalidad es que a mí me cuesta. Pero yo me voy guiando por sus ejemplos y por lo que pone los ejercicios, ¿no?
Ok, sí, por eso le decía que se quería practicar así, sin ver, sin leer, sino solo así, lo que va saliendo. Ok, for example, if I ask you, what is your middle name, Verónica?
Es Susie.
Susie, ok. And which name do you like most, Verónica or Susie? Which name do you prefer?
Verónica.
Ah, ok. Do you have children, Verónica?
Yes, 3.
Yes, I do. Ok.
Yes, I do.
3 children. Ok. How many girls or boys? How many girls or how many boys? ¿Cuántos? How many girls? How many boys?
2. 1 boys. 1 boy.
2 girls, 1 boy. 2 daughters, 1 son. Okay.
2 daughters. Daughters.
Yes.
1 son.
Okay. How old is your son?
Susie, 23 years old.
Susie is 23
years old. Natalia
is
17 years old, y Julio 13.
And years Julio old. Is 13
years old. 13 years old.
Okay, and where do you live, Veronica? Where are you from? I am from
I am from San Marcos.
Ah, okay. I am from Ilopango, but I live in on the way to Los Planes de Rendero. So we live close. Vivimos cerca. We live close.
Sí.
Okay, cerca. Veronica, you see? Good job.
Thank you.
Veronica, do you like pizza?
Poquito.
Just a little, okay.
Just a little.
Do you like pupusas?
Un poquito.
Just little. A little.
Just little.
Okay. Do you have
hamburger?
You like hamburgers. Okay. Do you have a dog or cat?
Ambos, no sé, together.
I have both. Both. Okay, both. Okay, you have a dog and a cat. What is your cat's name?
Blanky.
And your dog's name? Jesse.
Dog is Osa.
So you have two cats and one dog?
Yes.
Oh, interesting. Okay. Okay, Veronica, it was a pleasure to practice with you. Fue un gusto, it was a pleasure. It was a pleasure to practice with you.
Gracias. Thank you.
Have a good night.
Good night, teacher.
See you tomorrow.
Tomorrow.